All right, this is Nate Storey with Bright Agrotech, and this is part four of our series on potassium. And now I'm going to talk about how we treat potassium deficiencies and how we manage our system so that we don't end up with potassium deficiencies really regularly, because those can really cut into our productivity. So historically, we have had to supplement systems with potassium, whether it's a potassium carbonate or a potassium-based hydroxide. We're adding potassium to the system. And many folks who are adding like seaweed extracts, that kind of thing, they don't realize that they're also supplementing potassium. We use a seaweed extract in our system. It's got a rating of 0, 0, 10, okay? So this is our NPK rating. So this is kind of the kelp meal concentrate that we use has this rating. And you can see then that kelp and kelp meal is very, very high in potassium. Carbonates and hydroxides are also high in potassium. And the nice thing is they're not supplementing nitrogen or potassium. Okay, so we end up when we put phosphorus. So when we put like a potassium hydroxide, like caustic lye. Okay, caustic lye is a potassium hydroxide, KOH. This is caustic lye, okay? And this is something that we use when the pH is very low. We also have potassium carbonates, okay? So this is K, usually it's like a 2CO3. There's a few different carbonates there and bicarbonates. But, you know, we're adding carbonates and we're adding hydroxides, but they only work at low pHs because both of these substances are carbonates and hydroxides will raise our pH, right? These are very, very basic compounds. So this is one reason why a lot of people will use kelp to supplement potassium in their system, because it's pH neutral. So there are a lot of other substances that you can use. And depending on kind of how your system runs, you can choose from a number of different things, and I'm going to talk about those today. So far, we've just talked about mostly substances that we add to the solution. Now, you can spray something like kelp meal concentrate on the plant leaves, so you can apply it foliarly, which means that the plants absorb it directly through their leaves and can utilize it. But by and large, most people are adding like their kelp concentrates or their kelp meal concentrates to the water itself, which is easy, but not always the most efficient method. There are a few other things that we can also do this with. We use potassium sulfate, okay? So we use potassium sulfate here on occasion, and most potassium sulfate has the rating 0, 0, 50, okay? So this is a very fast response, super fast response potassium addition for systems. And if you are experiencing a potassium deficiency and you want to treat it in the solution, I would highly recommend using potassium sulfate because you get very quick results. Now you can't really apply this foliarly. That's one drawback. You don't want to be spraying potassium sulfate on your leaves, but you know, it works to correct these deficiencies fairly fast in solution. Now, if you're seeing deficiency symptoms and you need to treat it right away, we're talking like within the next 1 to 2 weeks, then you're going to have to use potassium chloride. Okay, so potassium chloride, it's a simple salt. A lot of people use it in de-icer, so a lot of de-icing salts use potassium chloride. And it's a great thing to use for foliar applications, okay? So make sure that you check out the Vertical Food blog. I'll talk about how to dose potassium chloride. But I usually recommend somewhere around like an eighth of a teaspoon, okay, a very small amount for each gallon of water that you're going to apply foliarly. And I want to make this clear, you apply this foliarly, not in solution, okay? We don't want to be adding this to our solution. So this is a really great way to get a super fast response out of your plants if you start to see a potassium deficiency begin to develop. So these are a few different options you have for treating potassium deficiencies in your system. Before you do any treatment, please read the Vertical Food blog blogs on this subject. They're going to talk in enough detail that you can make the right decision regarding which one is the best to use and how much to dose it with. Now, none of these things are going to destroy your system if you add them. You know, the big thing with foliar applications of anything is you can burn your plants if you apply it at the wrong rate. So it's always important to know kind of what rates you're applying, what substances you're using, and make sure that you're applying them at appropriate rates to address kind of the need of your system. So please, please, please do read the Vertical Food blog post on these on this subject. I'm going to go into a lot of detail for you there, and I don't want you to go out and just dump a whole bunch of potassium sulfate in your system and see something crazy happen because you didn't know what you're doing. So please do check out the blog, and I'm going to go into as much detail as possible to make this really easy for you. Thanks for watching this four-part series. If you find this information valuable and helpful, please check out the Vertical Food blog, and also please do check out our products on ZipGrow.com if you're thinking about starting a system. This is Nate Storey with Bright Agrotech. Thanks so much for watching.